not fear, for it is I, Wrestlemane, Grimfangs. Listen to me, there are no others left to carry on this fight. You have been left in the cell to die. Jaeger Thorn. Imperial Battle Mage, I guess? Yeah, I suppose so. Battle Mage of Tamriel has taken on the guise of the true Emperor. He does not see you as a threat, being only a minor part of the Imperial Court. In that act of arrogance, he made his first mistake. Look to the north wall of the cell. You will find a ruby key which will unlock this door. Take it and make your escape. The passages here were once used by... Click them. Click? Yeah. Thorn to hide treasures he had stolen from the Emperor's coffers. If you wish, you can gather enough to support yourself away from the Imperial seat. Be careful, as there are many creatures which inhabit the sewers now, wild rats and goblins. It is too late for me, I'm already dead. Only my powers as a sorceress keep me between this life and the afterlife and the next. The power, however, is waning. Do not succumb to greed, or you may find these tunnels to be your final resting place as well. I still work my magic to a certain extent. If you travel west from the cell, then south, you will find a shift gate. It will transport you to far enough from the center of the Empire. Thorn has taken on the guise of the Emperor. No one will gainsay his words over yours. It is imperative that you rest from time to time. In that way, I'll be able to communicate with you and lend my aid. You're entering a dangerous area. Beyond your moral comprehension, I do not envy your role. There is, however, a power with you as yet untapped. Look for me when you have gained experience. Really? When you gain XP? In the world, you are my last and best of all. Save it this order. Man, this game has got a lot of... Wait, WASD doesn't work? Let me just save it real quick. Yeah, details. More details are good. So I use the mouse to turn? Man, these controls are archaic. And this game's got a lot of text. Feels like I'm actually reading a novel of some sort. Imperial Dungeons, 12:03 in the afternoon. Tirtas, the first of Earthfire. Well, it's good to see that they actually made the dating system back then. Like, the dates and calendars. Let's go! That's not really a ruby glint. That's gold, man. Ah, I can see it on the top left corner of the screen. That's something. Wolfenstein, I guess? I mean, this game sort of reminds me of that. That's good. That's good to know. What's... loot? Is that? Ooh, 90 gold pieces and a kite shield. So, like, I have no idea what that does. So anyway, let's just get moving, I guess. West then south. The compass is going west right now, so I guess I'll just keep going west. What was that sound? Is somebody attacking me? I think somebody's attacking me. What? Is that a mouse attacking me? Yeah, somebody's definitely... Oh, is that a mouse's tail? And I already got a disease. Okay. I'm gonna get... Alright, I'm gonna beat you up now. How do you attack in this? Wait, was it like clicking and dragging or something? It's not working! Attack, attack, attack. right, I'm just gonna... Yeah, I'm just gonna... What? It follows me! There's no option to flee. Let me try attacking. Clicking and drag, click and drag, click and drag. What? Right click and drag, perhaps? Okay. Yeah, there we go. Right click and drag. And at this point I'm so devoid of health that I guess I might as well reload at this point. So cool. Wait a minute. All the loot is randomized? So I didn't get the guide shield this time? I guess. Alright, let's move on. But wait, how do I equip what I get? That's basically attacking, but right and left. That's cool. Well, we want attack animation. We want multiple. Quite a lot of effort for something that was deployed in a CD-ROM. No, wait, not even a CD-ROM. A floppy disk, like those 2 MB floppy disks. Quite impressive. That's the map. So that's basically asking me to go south. Ooh! A goblin! Hit him. Ooh, down in one strike. Weak ass goblins. Can I? Ah, yes. A dagger. How do I equip that though? I mean, yeah, I don't have the dagger right now. Yeah. Okay. Do I click on myself? Okay. Ah, there we go. So wait, I've already got a broadsword. Might as well use it then. Nah, not a dagger. No. Broadsword it is. The area seems quite confusing, and I guess that's another dead end there, so... Huh. Where do we go? Back the way we came, I guess. And the path to the right looks like it would lead to the same area, but yeah, we don't really know, so might as well just check it out once. And it's a dead end. Huh. That was something. Another goblin. Swing it, sword. Am I colliding with the walls or something? No, I finally got him. Wait, what's still attacking me? Another goblin. That is with you. Ooh, I can add more strength now. I think I'm gonna increase my... What am I gonna increase? Strength, yeah, strength. The vitality, I think? Let's see what happens. Luck, and yeah. Persuasion, I guess? Or perception, yeah, I think it should be perception. Coming back from the D&D theme. This goblin's got a staff, and... well... What does this goblin have? Another staff. Quarter staffs. That's nice. That's another niche. And this... I guess I'll just rest here until I'm healed then. Yeah, that's it. 5 hours have passed. 19, 20, 21, 22. Well, what is that? See, you have strengthened your arm and your mind. It's time we began this journey. The Staff of Chaos, the one item that can open the door between Oblivion, the world and the dimension to which the Emperor has been banished. Oblivion. Tarn used this item. Chaos was nigh indestructible, having been made from the essence of the land itself, but in that he found the key. As land is split, so did he shatter this staff into eight fragments. Okay, perfectly formed pieces. These are scattered across the realm. I have been able to divine the location of the first piece, a place called Fanglair. Okay, so I guess we're going to Fanglair once we get out of this mess, this dungeon. It is said that Fanglair was originally built by the dwarves of Cregan. Legend has it that a great worm drove the dwarves. Oh boy. Dragons. This early in the game, I thought. This early? Dragons? I don't really know. This is starting to sound more and more like The Hobbit. The Desolation of Smaug, if you know what I'm talking about. Thank you, I guess. That's cool. What does this talk to? A staff. Not that looks badass. But nah, I think I'm gonna hold on to the broadsword instead. So apparently we need to go and... Okay... Alright, moving on. So apparently we need to escape this dungeon and then go to this place called Fanglair. And with the way that the game has been, I don't really know how we're supposed to find that out. I mean, do we just keep exploring the wilderness until we finally find the Fanglair? And it's at best then south, so I guess we're just gonna go south at this point. Or should we go west? I don't know. Oh, another goblin. Die! Yeah, that taught you. Ah, 3 gold pieces. What a miser. Is that loot? Can I loot it? Doesn't seem like I can. Oh well. And this here seems to be another dead end, so I guess we're going south. As the lady told us to. What was that? And this is another dead end. Or is it? Wait, can we actually get into the water? I think we can. Let's try it. Can we swim? I mean, what's the worst that's gonna happen? We're gonna die, right? Okay. Ooh. Wait, we can swim. Let me get up. Wait, what? Why can't I move? Ooh, that showed you. Hmm. So, goblin, how does it feel to be stuck behind a door? Wait, another one. Where do these people come keep popping from? Like, seriously. Nothing usable, nothing. Why do you even exist? What do you have? Again, nothing usable. Oh my god. Okay. Oh, at least you had a staff. So, I think I'll just go keep going south at this point. I don't know. Another goblin. Man, they really spammed the area with goblins, didn't they? A buckler. Let's just quickly equip that. If you can, of course. But which way do we go first? Which way do we go? The buckler. Yeah, right there. That doesn't look half bad. Pretty nice, to be honest. Let's go. So, yeah, south, I guess. Keep going south until we hit a dead end or something. Are there gonna be any spiders? Ooh. I got a longsword now. Alright, that's another way there, so I think I'm gonna be going down that. But first, let me see here. Longsword. No, I think the broadsword is better, so I think I'm gonna stick to that instead. Moving on. That seems to be dead. A skeever. Really? A skeever? Huh. That was an anticlimactic dead end, so... The rat has nothing usable. Really? Why do they even keep making enemies with nothing usable? Alright, now, I did not see that entrance there, so let's try and go ahead and see what it has to offer. Did that actually... Okay, now we're sealed in here. And I'm diseased. Huh. Man, this game is difficult. I guess it's just one of those things which the older games had, that they just purposefully made them like super difficult to play. Can I get out of here? Can I like open this gate or something? No? Okay. So I guess I'll try going left this time around. Where was that part? Where was that door? Was it through here? No. Okay. Can I actually swim through that part? Right there? Seems a little low. No. Oh yeah, I can. I can swim through here. Alright, let's see where this is going. So that's where I came in at, and I guess this might end up somewhere good. Let's see. That should be my cell, I guess. I don't know, I mean... I could have sworn I marked my cell there. Did I take that path? Are those pathways? Yeah, I guess that's where I came in through, so... Wait, that was a secret gate, was it? Yeah, I'm just gonna name it Goblin Gate for the time being, and let it say there. Moving on. Wait a minute. I just realized these are sewers. I'm actually swimming in the sewers. The stuff that you have to do to escape. Oh my. Look at that. We found so much treasure. More rats. Piss off, guys. I'm already diseased. Oh yeah. A level of experience. I guess I could increase speed a little. That seems to be good. That seems to be good. Did my background change? I think it did. Resting, 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 resting. There are enemies nearby. Oh boy. Ooh, who's this dashing good fella? Die, die. No? Feels like I'm not even doing any damage. Damn, he's powerful. And I is dead. What, that's it? Literally? Like, literally that's it? Alright, so I just died, and I think the best choice at this point is just flee. Like, stop everything you're doing and flee, because otherwise... Well, this game is just way too difficult to actually, like, complete. The enemies do way too much damage, and yeah. Well, that's all too. And I think I'm gonna try fleeing this way. 6 gold pieces, okay, the loot this time around isn't that good. Stuff, hey! So... let me just get a quick inventory here. What do I have? 3 staffs, a dagger, a broadsword, and a torch. So I guess that works. Gotta make do with what I have, yeah? Alright, moving on. Yeah. Was that a thrust? There are actually a lot of attack animations in this game. I like that. Can I pull for it? Looks like I can't. What are these here for, though? I guess we'll just have to flee from them now. Iskramor, forgive me. A mighty Nord warrior fleeing from enemies like a skeever in the sewers. I can't even go there. Sun God shall have to remain a dream for me. Let me just go back the way I came, quickly. I mean, I'm pretty sure we can take them on, but, yeah. Let's just... I mean, we've already been there, so let's try to find some place we haven't gone so that we can actually, you know, like, find the way to escape. I guess we'll start with this part here. That would be my cell there, and, that's Goblin Gate right over there. I guess we head straight. How about that? Yeah. Let's try going here. This game is actually quite confusing. I mean, it sort of makes me two goblins. Is there any way to flee? Yeah, I think so. I can see something shimmering over there. Move, damn it. Yeah. Yeah, this game actually makes you appreciate all the convenience that modern games offer you. You know, especially like if you've played Skyrim. That stuff is actually like super easy to figure out and quite intuitive to play. And this game, on the other hand, at this point I've got like two things to do. I've got to... wait, that does not look like that's going in the right direction, so... I guess I'll just check around the other way, but then again, that one was going in the wrong direction anyway, so... Let's see. So yeah, I mean, it really... In this game, you have to figure out not only how to play this game, but also what you're supposed to do, and where you're supposed to go. And while the exploration is still a part of Skyrim as well, it's not such a huge part as it is in this game. Plus, the combat in that game is much easier. Of course, it has nothing. It's a fucking skeever. So yeah, the combat in that game is much... Ooh, some loot. The combat in that game is much easier, and it sort of balances out the exploration part, that you can like actually explore, and I think the one which we previously wore was better than the one which we have equipped right now, so I think, yeah, that's better. Anyway. So yeah, you can actually explore in those games and like freely. If you face difficulties, you can actually like combat your way out of it. You don't exactly need to, you know, like just be cautious about what you explore and how you explore it, how you go about exploring. Like, there's no pressure on you to leave the area quickly or just you know, rush around, try to find an exit as soon as you can, and yeah, so that's that. So wait, is that a goblin there? I can't reach it. Well, that's unfortunate. Can I get up? No, I can't. I've got to kill this goblin. Are you kidding me? I can't even swing my sword in the water. Okay, time to... I guess I'll just kill this goblin, because otherwise this goblin's basically killing me, or I can just flee. So, yeah. I'm just going to choose flight over fight. Because this game certainly does not want you to fight most of the time. What now? What do we do now? So, I mean, one of the things which I find quite strange about the layout of this dungeon is that there are only so many like pathways which are physically accessible. Like, you can access on foot. The rest of it, you literally have to swim in the sewers, and that doesn't really make much sense to me. I mean, it seems quite impractical for the guards to actually been, you know, actually be loitering around in these places trying to keep the prisoners inside. But well, I guess it is what it is. So, yeah. Thank you. Wait, is that, are those skeevers? Yeah. Wait, did those skeevers push me off? Why can't I climb up? Like, seriously, let me goddamn climb. Like, swing. Yeah, thank you. Wait, one stroke didn't do it. You guys are seriously more dangerous than the goblins? Like, stop pushing me into the river, come on. That's where you guys belong, not me. Yeah, finally. Wait, another? Ugh, finally. I think I'm just gonna go back and rest there, so... Conveniently, we've got a perfectly sized niche here for us to rest on. And we cannot camp here because enemies are nearby. I honestly don't know what I should be doing here. I mean, I can't exactly camp, and if I move and encounter an enemy, well, that's basically the end of me, so... This seems like suicide anyway, so... You know what, I'm just gonna go for it. So, let's go. Let's go ahead and meet a dude. Is the exit, man. This game is actually getting quite frustrating at this point. Is that a goblin? I just killed three skeevers there and now I have to face a goblin as well? Well, guess I'll just die then. Bye bye, world. And there we have it again. So. I basically had to take a break back then, and because this game is frustratingly difficult and I can't find a way as to where I need to go to like escape this dungeon, so, well, I guess I'm just gonna make a run for it this time. Here goes nothing. Anyway, let's go here. No, not this way, no. Let's just go the previous way. Let's just go the way we went when we first were trying to escape. When we were first trying to escape this place. So, yeah, down here. Okay, flight successful until now. And I'll be dealing with you momentarily. Wait, you mean to tell me that you can actually hit me, but I can't hit you while I'm underwater, while I'm swimming? Well, that seems a tad unfair, doesn't it? Wait, let me just grab you quickly. You right here. Die. Oh, the timing on that couldn't have been better. What do you have for me? 21 gold pieces, awesome. See, that's the sort of goblins that you want to encounter. A dead end, like seriously? Alright, now where do we have to go then? We tried that way, it didn't work out. I mean, it seemed to just, you know, lead deeper into the cells, so... This place, wait, it's not a dead end, it's a secret door! How are you supposed to open these doors then? Would you die already, please? Thank you. God damn the combat system. I mean, this is practically the combat system from D&D. Ooh, 52 gold pieces. I mean, I wish I could have had the loot which I had in the first part, so... Oh, it's this place. Alright, let's Let's keep moving now. I mean, if I had known that I can actually swim through those tunnels of sorts the first time around, then it would have been much different, but yeah. Well, I guess you live and you learn. Or in this case, you die and you learn. So, should I go this way? I mean, that sort of looks like we're going the other way, so I think we'll just keep swimming. And skeevers, really? I mean, are these skeevers or are these rats? I mean, they used to call them skeevers in Skyrim, and they practically look the same, but I think these are skeevers. I think I'll keep going straight then, I suppose. Let's just keep going straight and no. Okay, alright. Time to where did it go? Where did you go? Seriously, I need to move in order to kill you? Oh my god. And we already reached it. It was that simple. I thought this was supposed to be a part of the floppy disks which came out, but yeah, apparently it isn't. Anyway, so I actually looked it up, and I looked it up from UESP, and apparently the cost for invisibility is 150. This was initially supposed to be a feature which was only for the copy disks, like for floppy disks, but I guess, I mean, the online version which Bethesda ported must have been from a floppy disk, because this feature is still here. This DRM protection, their version of DRM protection. So, anyway, so I guess that's all of that. That's it for this video. I mean, I'll catch you guys next time. Take care.